This is Vishwanath Chavan, Assistant Professor, Computer Science and Engineering Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Now I am here to explain operating modes of 8255. At the end of this session, the students will be able to differentiate bit set reset and input output mode. Let us see the control word format of 8255. 8255 is called programmable peripheral interface. So to know how it works, we should know how control word format of 8255 appears. So it is total 8 bits, bit D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6, D7. And the second row indicates the respective port cases, like D0, PCL, port C, lower bit, that is PC0 to PC3. And this port will be acting as a input if it is 1. If it is 0, then it acts as a output. Next, D1 bit indicates regarding port B. PB0 to PB7. If it is 1, port B act as a input. If it is 0, port B act as a output. Next, bit D2. Port B mode selection. That is concerned with D1, which is port B. So, selection of mode. There are two modes, mode 0 and mode 1. So, if this bit is 0, then port B will be in mode 0 operation. If it is 1, then it will be in mode 1. Next, D3 bit, which is PCU, port C upper part, PC4 to PC7. If it is 1, then port C upper part will act as an input. If it is 0, then it acts as an output. Next, D4, which is port A, PA0 to PA7. If this bit is 1, it acts as a input. If it is 0, it acts as a output. Next, two bits, D5 and D6. These two bits are reserved for port A mode selection. So there are three modes, mode 0, 1, 2. If it is 0, 0, these two bits are 0, 0, then it will be under mode 0. If it is 0, 1, then it will be under mode 1. If it is 1, don't care, then it will be under mode 2 operation. Last bit, which is D7. If this bit is 0, then it will be under bit set reset mode. If it is 1, then it will act as a IO mode. Now we'll see more detail with example. So the first three rows are already explained in the previous slide. Now let us see one example. D7 bit 1, which indicates that it is in input output mode. Next, two digit D6 and D5, if both are 0, 0, then it will be under mode 0 operation. Next bit 1, that is port A, 1 means it acts as the input. That is, port A is going to act as the input. Then port C upper part is 0, indicates that port C upper part will act as the output. D2 bit 0, which indicates that port B is under mode 0 operation. Next bit, port B is 1, which indicates that port B is in input mode. Last bit 0, which indicates that PC lower part will act as a output. This is how we need to interpret the all 8 bits. So this is binary whose equivalent value is 92H. Let us see how bit set and reset format works. Total there are 8 bits, D0 to D7. If D7 is 0, then it will be under bit set reset mode. And next three, that is D6, D5, D4, these are don't care conditions. Next three, D3, D2, D1, which is reserved for port C, bit set and reset. The respective port will be reset if this D0 bit is 0. It will be set if it is 1. Let us see with an example. 0000, 0011. So how to interpret these 8 bits? This 0 indicates that no, this is under bit set reset mode. Next 3 digits 0. Since it is don't care, it doesn't matter whether it is 0 or 1. Next 3 bits reserved for port C, which is 001, which indicates that port C1. We'll see how exactly it is going to assign. Then this is port C1 will be set. 1 means set. This is how 03H indicates that port PC1 bit is set. So we'll see one more example which is concerned with reset. Since this is in BSR mode, it should be 0. Next don't care 3 values. Next 001, same PC1, but instead of 1, if it is 0, which indicates that reset. That is port C1 bit is reset. So how port C value is calculated? Port C0 means D1, D2, D3 values will be 0, 0, 0 respectively. Port C1, 1. Port C2, 2. Port C3, 3. Next, 4. Up to PC7. So, based on this 0, 0, 1 in the previous slide, which is here, 0, 0, 1, which indicates that port C bit number 1. So we can use respective value to set reset the port C. So think on this question and try to answer. The question is, how many mode selections are there for port A and port B? Pause this video and write your answer. I hope you are done. So the answer is, for port A, 3 modes are there, mode 0, 1, 2. And for port B, 2 modes, mode 0 and mode 1. So regarding input-output mode, if MSB of control word D7 is 1, then programmable peripheral interface works in input-output mode. This is further divided into 3 modes. So we'll focus on all 3 modes. Mode 0. In this mode, all the 3 ports, which are port A, B, C, can work as input function or output function. Depends on the value which is mentioned in the control word format. In this mode, there is no interrupt handling capacity. So, interrupt handling capacity can be overcome in upcoming modes. So, mode 1, which is a handshake IO mode. In this mode, either port A or port B can work as input or simple output port, and the port C bits are used for handshaking signals before the actual data transmission takes place. And mode 1, it has the capacity to handle the interrupt and input outputs which are latched. We'll see one example. The CPU wants to transfer data to a printer. So in this case, the speed of the processor is high compared to the speed of the printer. So the before actual data transfer, it will send handshake signal to the printer for synchronization. So this is how it sends. this is CPU, this is printer. So there are signals D0 to D7, bidirectional, strobe, acknowledgement, and busy signal. So this is how printer and CPU, they are interacting with each other with the help of handshaking signals. So next mode is mode 2. Bidirectional data bus mode. In this mode, only port A works and port B can work either in mode 0 or mode 1. 6 bits port C are used as handshake signal. And bit set reset mode. This mode is used to set or reset the bits of port C only and selected when the most significant bit D7 in the control register is 0. These are the references. Thank you.